to business, consumer to consumer expenditures will rise to $5.6 trillion in the next 5 years. The size of the food and agricultural market in Africa will rise to $1 trillion just in the next 10 years. Africa's continental free trade area, which unites all the economies of the continent, will be worth a whopping $3.3 trillion alone. That tells you that is the largest free trade zone in the world.
Nigeria is the powerhouse, and I think that there's tremendous opportunity. Now, in the first place, you know, already quite a few Nigerian businesses are all over Africa, especially the services. Many Nigerian banks are already in various parts of Africa. Some of our companies, Dangote and Co., in 11 different countries in Africa and all that. So there are a few companies already. So there is already a footprint of Nigerian companies doing excellently all over the world. Now, in order to benefit from the Africa Continental Free Trade Agreements, the first thing is in developing our own capacity internally. Because what will happen eventually, this is a trade agreement. We're going to be exporting a lot of our products to different parts of Africa. So today, what a lot of small businesses are doing is, or should be doing, is ensuring that their products are world class, that they are excellent quality. There's so many people doing various things. People in the beauty products industry, for instance, in food. So many people working with soybeans, people working with various, with shea butter and all of that. There's so many different products that people are coming up with now. And those products are well packaged and they are, in many cases, world class. So I think that the first thing to do is to develop our capacity locally, because while we're waiting, we're still negotiating many of the aspects of the free trade agreement. So it hasn't really taken off. So now, while we're still negotiating, while there's still time, it's important to develop one's capacity. And when you're developing your business locally, you must be thinking internationally. You must be thinking, how will what I'm producing here meet international standards?
But more generally on the issue of the loans, access to loans at high interest rate. I don't know what business you can do at an interest rate of 29% that you ever turn a profit. Even if you are selling drugs, you will not. So the issue is we have to make capital affordable, available and affordable for people. And in particular, as the Vice President was saying, for small and medium-sized enterprises. So I think the key really is this. Sometimes you ask the bankers, I'm a banker, you ask some of the bankers that are here, they will tell you it's risk. Project risk, financial risk, market risk, political risk, all kind of things, all risk. But in fact, I'm not sure whether it's really all those things that are risk. I think a lot of time it's just the bias risk, bias. Perceived risk, a bias risk against lending to a young person, lending to small and medium-sized enterprises. When somebody walks into the bank and the person is a young person, is 21 years old, you ask the person, go and bring your tax returns for the last 15 years. Where? You ask them to go and bring the collateral. How will they have collateral? And so I think what's important is that we have to understand that young people are the best assets we have.